Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market has recorded a slight price change for the last 24 hours. That's why I would say that the major cryptocurrencies, their prices are just moving sideways. And since today is Monday, and usually on Mondays I analyze the price chart of Bitcoin, let's move on to the price chart of Bitcoin and let's conduct a thorough technical and candlestick analysis. So the current price is $10,958. And this is the linear chart for the last 12 months. And this is the daily chart, the candlestick chart, and I would like to say that usually I start from the monthly time frame, but as a short reminder, in the daily time frame, I want to outline that we've been following this symmetrical triangle. So this is the symmetrical triangle. Let me just a little bit make thicker these lines. And actually, we know that a symmetrical triangle, according to the theory of candles, technical analysis, is a trend continuation pattern, and we know that the price chart entered the symmetrical triangle from an uptrend. So usually if the price chart exits the triangle, it just renews the upward direction. And we know that not long time ago, the price chart was consolidating at the upper line of the triangle, and after that the price started to increase. So it may turn out that this is the beginning of this exit from the triangle, and probably this is the beginning of the renewal of the uptrend. Once again, I want to mention that in the worst case, if we have a deeper pullback, price pullback, I would like to mention as before that probably in the worst case, the price chart of Bitcoin may test the upper line of this triangle, and after that probably it will rebound once again. So this is the let's say the worst or the most pessimistic scenario. I just wanted to outline it once again, but who knows, it may turn out that we have a beginning of trend renewal or uptrend renewal here. So let's now analyze the price chart in the major time frames. So this is the monthly time frame. We're very familiar with all those candlesticks. We know that there was a solid, and actually it is in the chart, this solid bullish candlestick in July, according or indicating that the bulls are trying to renew the uptrend. Unfortunately, in August we had this small dodge, so a candlestick with a small body and with equal upper shadow and equal lower shadow. After that, in September, we have unfortunately this bearish candlestick that covers the body of the Doge, or it engulfs the body of the previous candlestick, and it has already a local high below the previous one and already a local low below the previous one. So this is a bearish signal indicating that bears are trying to gain control over the market. However, I would like to mention that till the end of the month we have 10 more days, so the situation may change. Hopefully it will be nice if it improves. But even if we have such kind of candlestick at the end of the month, yes, it will be a bearish signal, but there are some slight let's say some very interesting technical patterns or formations in the shorter time frame. So let's move to the shorter time frames and see if they may cancel this let's say negative signal coming from this potential bearish engulfing. So in the weekly time frame, here is the fluctuation of the price for the last, let's say, half a year. We're very familiar with all those ups and downs. Recently there was a solid price decline followed by a small dodge. Last week I think I mentioned that this dodge indicates that the price chart is receiving some support, and it was in the lower part of the price range of this solid bearish candlestick, and once again it just indicated that the price is facing some solid support. After that the price rebounded, and last week we had this bullish candlestick with a local low above the previous one and with a local high above the previous one. So to some extent, it is a slight signal that probably the bulls will try to retake control over the market and to renew the uptrend. But let's see what's going on in the shorter time frames. I will skip the daily time frame for now. For the moment, I will move on to the 4-hour chart, and after that I will return to the daily chart, because this rebound here, this potential renewal of the uptrend, is easily visible in the 4-hour chart. For example, if we draw the uptrend line something like this, I just want to mention that last week I outlined this potential uptrend as well. So who knows, it may turn out that this is the renewal of this ascending channel, of this uptrend, after this consolidation at the lower line of this ascending channel. Some traders claim that this is an ascending narrowing wedge. Okay, that's okay. It is, the idea is almost similar, that we have this ascending channel or ascending movement. And let's cross our fingers that this is the beginning of some price increase or uptrend renewal, because as mentioned in my previous analysis, this rebound happened at levels close to the levels of that local high and that local high. So if I draw a horizontal line like this, let me just change the style of this horizontal line. I just want to mention that that was the local high from that formed in February of this year. So this is actually the range of that local high. Here is the very similar range of this consolidation at the lower part of this ascending channel. It was also almost the same range as the range of this local high that formed during the period of this descending channel that we used to follow, and that was the last local high within this channel, within this triangle. I talk about it many times, so we are very familiar with this logic. So once again, this is the last local high within this descending triangle. But as I mentioned before, I think the most solid and reliable support for the price of Bitcoin is at the level of the local of the lower line of this descending triangle. So it is something like 9,500 plus minus, let's say, $300 or $400. So probably if we have some pullbacks, the price of Bitcoin will receive a very solid support at the level, at that level. And it is also the level similar to the consolidation of the price of Bitcoin before the solid price increase. So once again, I think that this is a very solid, let's say, support level or even a range. But who knows, it may turn out that this is the beginning of the price increase, the renewal of the price increase, that may take the price of Bitcoin to levels close to the previous local high, or even surpass, the price chart may surpass the level of the previous local high if the bulls have enough strength to push the price further up. So let's cross our fingers for Bitcoin. I will follow the price movement, the current price movement, and in case I see that the price exit or break down the lower line, what I would consider as a bearish signal, I will mention it as a comment under this video. So if you follow the price chart of Bitcoin, you can come back periodically and check the comments under this video. So that's it for today, fellas. Please share your point of view as a comment under this video. I wish you a wonderful weekend, a very productive weekend. And of course, hope to see you in the next video. It was me at CryptoSpark.